Lake Mead welcomes over 6 million guests every year, but the invitation is not extended to one particular group of visitors, the quagga mussels.
Obviously, Lake Mead Marina is an absolutely beautiful, stunningly beautiful place. But in this beautiful environment, there is a tiny little problem.
Here's a man that's going to tell us more about it. Kamood, how are you?
I'm very well.
Scientist Kamood Akaria has been researching the species for almost a decade.
How did they get here in Lake Mead?
They came here on boats. Yeah. When people moved their boats from one lake to another lake. You know.
And when do you think that happened?
They were found here or discovered here in 2007. So probably slightly before that they were here.
That's not long ago. They really multiply fast?
Oh yeah. I mean, you know, in some places in Lake Mead you can find 600,000 to 700,000 per square meter of mussels.
An adult quagga mussel averages 2 inches in size, and a female can produce up to 1 million eggs per year. Individuals live from 3 to 5 years and have little to no predation.
I mean, what happens if we don't get a handle on this?
Yeah, that's a really good question, John, because, you know, we've had these mussels like zebra mussels and quagga mussels from the 80s in our Great Lakes. So eventually what happens is we haven't been able to take care of them or eradicate them. We just learn to live with them. They just, you know, everything that is a point, carrying capacity, we call it, right? So even Lake Mead has a carrying capacity for these mussels. There'll be a point where they'll reach to an equilibrium. I mean, having said that, there are many, many scientists working on trying to find a way to get rid of them.
These mussels clog pipes and engines, damaging water systems and boats. They also disrupt the food chain and pollute beaches with sharp shells.
So Lake Mead has three intake pipes. There are two intake pipes already built to supply drinking water to the city of Las Vegas. We have Hoover Dam, we have Penn State, anything on the water are all covered with mussels.
So what do you do about that?
You have to send out divers to clean that out, and you have to send up divers with power hose.
So the economic impact is real, it's severe.
It's huge. It's costing us money.
How much money do you think it's costing?
Well, you know, there are different numbers have been thrown around, but people think that the U.S. government spends close to $1 billion a year to deal with invasive mussels.
So if you have a message for anybody that's watching, you bring a recreational vehicle in here, have it checked out?
Absolutely. You have to go through that inspection. And if your boat has ever been to this lake, and you have to make sure that you take nothing home.
And is that what's going up on that hill right
That's
there?
That's what is happening over there.
I got to go check that out.
Cool.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely.
For your time.
Absolutely.
I really appreciate it.
Well, yeah. I learned a lot. Thank you.
Thanks.
The inspection aims to contain the spread of the mussels between waterways by power washing any vessel before it goes into a different body of water.
Seth, how you doing, man?
Good, how are you?
Good to see you.
You as well.
Seth works with the Nevada Department of Wildlife. He's battled quagga mussels here for 2.5 years through the Aquatic Invasive Species Program.
What makes them so bad?
The growth rate is one of the biggest things. Especially with our climate, they grow year-round, so there's no really chance for them to stop growing.
And how do people interact, or where do you find them, or where do they show up?
Usually if people are moored, you know, they're staying week to week to week, you know, or months, and they'll start to grow on the boat.
So you have to have some sort of management plan, I guess, of these things.
Yeah, our biggest thing right now is to contain them. We don't want anyone else to get them.
What's amazing to me is that there's no easy solution, is it? I mean, it just comes down to good old-fashioned elbow grease.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, you know, we work hard to try and contain it here.
And who's this and what's going on?
This is Blake. He's a part of our AIS program as well.
And Blake,
he's
been here. Nice seeing you.
How's it going?
He's getting prepared to wash the boat, basically, do our decontaminating treatment.
All right, now that sounds like a lot of chemicals and a lot of toxins, but it's not, is it?
No, we actually only use hot water, basically.
I mean, really?
We heat the water up to about 140 to 150 degrees.
There are two inspection stations at Lake Mead and one at Lake Mojave. In 2015, 444 boats were decontaminated. The inspections are free of charge.
A few minutes ago, this thing was just covered in these mussels, and they just continue to multiply unless you deal with it. Now it looks to me like it's all done, but I guess it's not. There's something else you got to do. What's the next step here?
So as well as washing the outside, we also clean out the system. And one of the things we do is we put the clamps right here, and then we supply water to the engine, and then we actually have them start the engine and run it. So with doing that, we're able to supply the engine with the water so we don't damage anything. And then the 140 degree water kills everything that's inside.
It's elbow grease and there's no easy way out, so I'm wishing you the best.
Well, we appreciate it.
Every time you enjoy Lake Mead on the surface, remember to do your part to prevent what spreads underneath.